YouTubers, I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. Been watching the live webcam there at Old Faithful, and I noticed here at the river, this one hot spring that's in the river, it is really dark. Now you can tell by the colors of the other monitors that this one's been getting darker too, and so these, but I don't think I've ever seen there in the river, the steam coming up there so dark, and that means there is excessive heat melting the rock. The water heats up and melts the rock and brings up that dark, almost black plume. Yeah, I recorded it a little bit, and look at that. It's like, oh my goodness. They're reporting a magnitude 2.6 earthquake there in the Madison River area. And it's currently 17 degrees. It's supposed to be as high as maybe 22 and then drop down to zero, I guess, tonight. Look at that. That is black as burning tires, black as coal. Utterly amazing. Now, another thing that's real interesting about this river. This river actually is kind of has a dike, like a dam under the ground that prevents much of the water from the one side to cross over, and the heat and the magma. Yeah, it keeps it over there because it's past magma that has come up through dike intrusion that formed a dam along here. And this over here up on the right, that would be the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. Yeah. Another thing I noticed, if they'll move the camera later, is because of the uplift there at Old Faithful. Now, Old Faithful, the hotels and parking lot, was all built on the hydrothermal system that feeds into Old Faithful. They didn't know that. They didn't do much research before building the hotels and the parking lot. I noticed the one area, the trees were leaning because of uplift. And, I just like to, this is amazing. See how dark this is getting over here, too? Yeah. All right. So let's look at the live stream. I got four monitors that I downloaded. The one here at the bottom is Holmes Hill. That's closest to where the earthquake occurred. This other one here is Western Boundary above it. This one here is Little Thumb Creek, West Thumb, I call it. And the one at the top is Soda Butte. And you can see we got multiple earthquakes here. All right. We got another earthquake coming in here. Maybe that's why it's so dark currently there. All right, we'll take another look. See what we got going on here. Might hear some noises of birds in the background. I'm currently watching my web camera that I have set up for the birds. Yeah, I got crows coming and different things. Different birds and squirrels. So I thought I'd take another peek while I'm downloading data. Yeah, look at that. You know, I was wondering if maybe a fault zone opened up through here, because normally this area does not ever show that dark of steam coming up. So it looks like yellow, our Old Faithful's trying to go off. It's kind of dark too. That one spot by the river was really dark, and so I've been watching what's going on here. Yeah, maybe they moved the camera after it had already gone off. It looks like there's water here, yeah, in the channel. So they must have missed it. And, of course, the boreholes aren't working, so I wasn't able to download that data. So here's supposedly the 2.6. Yeah, and looks like Holmes Hill is the best monitor, it looks like. Okay, let's go to the spectrogram. That was the closest to it. You know, after looking, watching, measuring all these earthquakes, yeah, I can tell before I even put in the tabs that it was not no 2.6. Probably closer to a 3.0. I gave him the benefit of the doubt and put in shortened it up, the seismic signature. You can see down here where it still rattled on before another quake. But it comes in as a magnitude 2.94. So that would have been at 8:45 a.m. We got another little one right there. But I'll do the one marked in red. I don't know if they reported it. Let me see. They did report a 1.1 at 15:48, 4 miles in depth. The 2.6, yeah, I'll just call it a 3.0, was actually 4.7 miles in depth. The 1.1, same location. This here is a monitor for Holmes Hill. And this is the area. Let me zoom in a little bit to the 2.6. You can see there's a lot of quakes along here. Okay, let's bring this back out. Okay. And we come out a little bit farther. Okay. That's that fault line. And it goes all the way down there to the geyser basin. Now, I did add in this small little quake afterwards. You can see it there. Let's go to the seismic signature. Too small. Let's make it bigger. There it is. No, I didn't. Oh, yeah, right there. Okay. Anyways, it comes in as a magnitude 2.01. Now, if I was to take that out, let me adjust this. And we'll go back to before the little one. It comes in as a magnitude 1.85. Ain't no 1.1. That's for darn sure. Yeah, if pigs could fly, maybe. This one they're not reporting right there at 15:49. So we'll go there and we'll go right there. Okay, and that comes in as a magnitude 1.55. And this one too, which is, well, you can see we got some more here too, not being reported. This one not being reported. So you can watch and see how I do this. Okay, that comes in as a 1.59. 16:55. That would be at 9:45 a.m. today. Got another one not being reported. And got to get it right where it, let me show you. Right where it looks like it ended. We'll go to the seismic signature. Right there. It rattled on for a little bit. 1.42. And then down here we got another one. Let me make that bigger, because my program always makes it little. Okay, right there. Oh, there's two of them. So it probably continued. And it's shaking. So if we add in the two, which they often do, that comes in as a 1.69. Or if we just do the first part of the quake, that would be a 1.25. But either way, it's not being reported. And again, this is the monitor for Holmes Hill. Now up over here, this is probably that earthquake that occurred there in Japan that shook up the caldera. You can see the line of melt. Let's go see what the line of melt was showing when I pulled the files. Again, Holmes Hill. And we got another one there. Another, what did they report it? 4:11. All right, they're saying that's a magnitude 0.4. Right. Okay, let's see what it was. We'll put it there and put it there. And it's actually a magnitude 1.18. Yeah. I don't know what they're drinking. what Kool-Aid they're drinking. I don't know. They are in Utah. I don't know if it's Utah or Menlo Park that is figuring out these earthquakes. 5:15 marked in red, but they're not reporting it. Surprise, surprise. And let's go back. Okay, probably. Well, maybe there. And that comes in as a 1.07. Yeah, I don't know. All right, the monitor for Soda Butte. That one's been screaming. Let's check it out. Yep, right there. Still doing it during that earthquake. Yeah, that 3.0. Okay. Let's see if I see anything else through here, which it might be, but sometimes they're really hard to see. But I can see that there. And let's go to Little West Thumb. West Thumb. See, these earthquakes show up on multiple monitors and they're not reporting it. Okay, this is West Thumb. No screaming there. Let's go to the spectrogram. And this is what it was showing when I pulled the files. Remember, West Thumb, Yellowstone Lake, they got that crack at the bottom of the lake. There's that other. Oh, no, there's that other earthquake right there. Yeah, not reporting. It was strong enough where it could be 1655. I'm pretty sure they're not reporting it. Yeah, they're not reporting it. Strong enough where they're showing up on multiple monitors, and there's another one there. I hate that. Quit going small on me. There you go. Yeah, tectonic in movement. The plates are moving. Let's go to that one. Tectonic. And we'll go up. Yeah, there's that earthquake that happened in Japan this morning. Yep, shook up the caldera. Yep, sloshed that magma around. See how it's rounded tops? Sloshed it around there in the caldera. Yep. All right, they zoomed in a little bit. Again, this is the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. Seeing what's going on. This one's looking a little dirty too. And let's watch it for a minute to see how dark that still might be. You can see there a little bit better view that it's a hot spring or a spring there in the river. Still looking dirty. Yep. Anyway, so that's all I have for you right now. What are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for your support. If you wish to support my work, I'm on Patreon. You can do it just for $1 a month. Yeah, times are tough right now. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.